Cause we are a family whose hearts are blazing. So let's raise our candles and light up the sky, praying to our Father in the name of Jesus. Make us a beacon in darkest times.
Welcome to the Light of the Nations Gospel Program. I am Dr. Shalini Pallil from Cross TV Network, Duarte, California. First of all, I want to wish all of you a very blessed and happy 2019. Today is the first day of this year, and I know we have our anticipations, and some of us might have fears. However, the Lord help us to start this year aright with His blessings and with His presence that will be sufficient to carry us throughout this new year. Let us look to the Lord in prayer. Our Heavenly Father, we bless you and praise you for this new year that you've given to us, for your faithfulness, for your goodness, and for your mercy. You change not, and your compassions, they change not and fail not. At the beginning of this year, Lord, we lift up our eyes unto you, from whence comes our help. Our help comes from the Lord who made the heavens and the earth. Our trust is in you, Lord Jesus. You are faithful and you do not change. Your power has not changed. Your word doesn't change. You are the one who saw us through the last year, 2018, and we know that you're able and powerful enough and gracious enough to see us through this new year, 2019. We especially commit our program into your hands, that you will continue to make this a blessing to many people. Lord, we pray that you will help us to be instruments in your hands for the extension of your kingdom and for the glory of your name. Bless this session today. In Jesus' name we ask, amen and amen. I'd like for you to turn with me to the scriptures as found in the book of Psalms, Psalm 102, verses 25 through 27. The psalmist says, "Of old thou hast laid the foundations of the earth, and the heavens are the works of thine hands. They shall perish, but thou shalt endure. Yea, all of them shall wax old like a garment. As a vesture shalt thou change them, and they shall be changed. But thou art the same, and thy years shall have no end." Praise the Lord. What encouraging words for the start of this new year. So we read right now from the book of Psalms, telling us that, you know, everything around us changes. The heavens will change, the earth will change, but God, our God, will never change, and he will be the same yesterday, today, and forever. We know that years come and go. 2018 just went by, and we have stepped into 2019. We know that governments come and go. They don't always last. Today is the Democrats, tomorrow is the Republicans, and in all the world, each country, according to whatever system they have, no government is permanent. They come and they go. We know people live and they die. They're here today, but they're not there tomorrow. A generation comes and that's there today, but that generation passes away and a new generation comes in its place. Fashions, they come and go. Today, what is in fashion and style today might become absolutely unfashionable tomorrow. Fashions come and go. We know that. businesses rise and fall. Some businesses that were doing great in the beginning of the year, they actually wind up and they go bankrupt by the end of the year. So there is no guarantee or there is no stability for many of these businesses. We know that banks, they thrive. Sometimes there are banks that are thriving and then all of a sudden you hear that they have gone bankrupt. Even they change. Seasons come and go. We know that during the springtime, we all, excuse me, we all look forward to all those beautiful blossoms in different shades and different hues. They're pink, they're yellow, they're lilac, they're blue, they're white, they're orange, they're purple. All these different colors you can see so beautifully. God arranged them all for us to be able to see his handiworks, and that's spring. And then pretty soon it's summer. And after that, right after summer, we see the colors changing, especially in the East Coast and places like that. Those beautiful changes of color of rust and yellow and pink, they're so awesome. They look so beautiful, and it tells us that it is fall season or autumn. And then after that, it's winter. Everything is covered white with snow, glistening white snow. It's cold, not a leaf to be seen on a twig, and we know it is winter. They come and they go. How about technology? We know that technology also comes and it goes. What is relevant today becomes absolutely obsolete tomorrow. It's replaced by newer technology. How many of us remember those old phones, the big phones, and they used to ring so loudly? You could hear them from one room to the other room, the end of the house. But we don't have those anymore. Very few people, even the phone, I mean, they have been replaced by different kinds of phones that are not so huge and bulky and heavy, and they're not as noisy. And then we also know that we have cell phones today that we carry around with us wherever we go. The phones, our phones travel with us wherever we go. Easy access and easy to communicate. This is all the different changes that we have seen in technology over the years. We also know that cars change designs and speed and all those different features that are found in cars. They keep changing year after year and they get more advanced and more advanced. So many changes. We also saw, probably you had experienced many changes in 2018. And, you know, some of them were for the good and some of them were not for good. Everything changes. But the good news is that God never changes. Everything around us, whether it be relationships, whether it be technology, whether it be governments, whether it be health, all of these things, they change. But there is one person that doesn't change, and the psalmist just told us about him, and he is God. Our God never changes. Praise the name of the Lord. In Hebrews chapter 13 and verse 8, the Hebrew writer says, Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Praise the Lord. He does not change. His power does not change. His love doesn't change. His love for all of humankind doesn't change. His power to do anything and everything anywhere, and the power not to do certain things that should not be done, it doesn't change. His love for humankind, whether we are white or dark or yellow or red skin, it doesn't matter. God's love for all of humankind doesn't change. God's care for all of us doesn't change. He is still the same loving, caring, and all-powerful God. Praise the Lord. So what does that mean? It simply means this. What he did for you yesterday, he's able to do for you and for me today, and he's able to do for you and for me tomorrow. Praise the name of the Lord. What he was in 2018, he is still the same in 2019. People are afraid because they don't know what's going to happen in 2019. Every new year begins, and there's a lot of speculation by those who are not Bible scholars or Bible students or Bible-believing believers, and they are so scared, and they hear about things here and there, and they see the things that are happening before their eyes, and they are scared, and they wonder what's going to become of this world in 2019. Remember, the God who was in control in 2018 is the same one who is in control in 2019, and he will be in control forever. Praise the name of the Lord. He was and He is and He will be always. The one who helped you and me in 2018 is the one who's going to help you and me in 2019. Scripture tells us that the Lord is our helper. Indeed, He is our helper. When we study the Bible and go through the pages of the Bible, through all the books of the Bible, we see that God was always there, ever present, to help His people in the time of need. He is a source that we can rely upon at all times, in all places, for all things. We may have put our trust and our help may have been coming from our family, from our parents, from our neighbors, from our friends, from our fellow believers. But remember, even if all of them change and if none of them come to your rescue and to your help, there's one to whom we can always go to, and there's one who will never fail us, and His name is God. Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today, and forever. What about provision? We know there are famines and all these kinds of shortages, things that are going, and floods that will destroy the crops, and storms and all of these that actually destroy all the crops and all, and you wonder about your provision. Or maybe just thought because of all of this, there's a hike in prices and you wonder how you're going to be able to provide for your family and for yourself. These are genuine concerns that we have in our hearts and in our minds because we are human and we need food on the table for ourselves and to be able to feed our children and our grandchildren. But remember, the one who provided for you in 2018 is the one who's able to provide for you in 2019. And for those of us that know our God, those that trust in God and who know our Bibles, we know that the Lord who provided for the children of Israel, even when they started out on their wilderness journey, the one who took care of them and fed them through 40 years of wilderness journey hasn't changed, and He's still able. Even though we may not sow and we may not be able to reap like the way farmers reap or people that grow crops reap, you know, God is able to give us a rich harvest because He is our provider. Praise the Lord Jesus Christ. He never fails, and there is no shortage of supply in His storehouse. Praise be in the name of the Lord. Then you have this concern today. I mean, there's so much fear. You don't know where you can go because there's shootings, there's killings, whether it's in a airport, whether it's in a school, we send our children to, or it's in a public restaurant, or even just walking on the mall or someplace. You don't know because what is going to happen. You don't know when that sniper is going to go crazy and do the things that he does and kills innocent people and sometimes ends up killing himself. You remember the one who watched over you in 2018 is the one who's able to watch over you in 2019. And for those of us who believe in our God, we know that the Bible tells us that, behold, he that keepeth Israel, in your case and my case, behold, he that keepeth you and me, shall neither slumber nor sleep. In other words, God is always watching over us, and His eyes are always upon us to protect us, to deliver us, and to guard us. Then we have this constant battle, for those of us that are children of God, this constant warfare with the powers of darkness. Some of us have bigger battles than others, but every single one of us, we get a fair share of what it means to experience the powers of darkness that comes to fight against us and destroy us when we serve the Lord Jesus Christ and when we have accepted Him as our Lord and as our Savior. Just remember this, the God who delivered you in 2018 is the same. He is able and He will continue as we continue to trust in Him to deliver us in 2019. Praise the Lord. When He crushed the head of Satan on the cross of Calvary, it was not just for that time, for the believers of that time, but even today, that promise still stands and that victory still is relevant and it still stands. Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior, the great victor of all times. He destroyed the powers of darkness once and for all on the cross of Calvary when He crushed the head of Satan. And that is still relevant for you and for me. He is the one who fights our battle, and He will deliver us and give us the victory. Blessed be the name of the Lord our God. Amen. Sickness. Oh, if you are born a human, you will have sickness, one form or another, different times, some big, some small. Very few people, I believe, have walked the face of the earth that have never experienced any kind of sickness, any kind of disease. In fact, for that matter, the curse, or the after effects of the curse of Adam and Eve's sin in the Garden of Eden, it actually even trickled over to our beasts and our animals. They also get sick. Our cats get sick. Our dogs get sick. Our cows get sick. Our cattle get sick. Our horses get sick. There's sickness all around us. And this is all a result, or the part of the package that Adam and Eve received in the Garden of Eden as a consequence of their sin against God in Eden Gardens. So what do we do for our sickness? The one who healed us yesterday, the one who delivered us miraculously yesterday from all kinds of diseases and all kinds of sicknesses and all kinds of ailments, is the same one who was able to deliver us in 2019. His blood still has the power to heal us of every sickness and every disease. The Bible tells us that by his stripes we are healed. There's power in the blood of Jesus. There's power still in the stripes that Jesus took, not only for the forgiveness of our sins, but also for the healing of our bodies. That fountain still flows for healing for all those who will believe in him. Are you sick? Have you never experienced Jesus Christ? Have you rejected him? Have you turned your back against him? Maybe through ignorance, or maybe through arrogance, or maybe through unbelief, whatever may be the cause. If you are sick, and no matter how deadly your disease or sickness might be, I'm here, 2019, the first day of this year, to give you this good news. Come to the fount called Calvary that Jesus opened up, that came flowing from out of his body that was bruised and beaten, not just for the forgiveness of our sins, but also for the healing of our sick bodies. His blood is still powerful and able to heal us of every sickness and every disease. Blessed be the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Sins and forgiveness of sins. As long as you and I live in this flesh, there are sinful tendencies, and every now and then sin will come and try to overtake us. How do we win this battle? How do we overcome sin? And when we do fall, when we do fail him, how do we have ourselves cleansed? How can we have a clean slate all over again? Again, the answer is through the precious blood of Jesus that flowed from Calvary for your sins and for my sins. The one who forgave us in 2018 is the same one who is able and powerful to forgive us in 2019. Amen. The one who gave us power to overcome sin in 2018 is the same one. As we trust in him, and as we obey his word, and as we submit ourselves to him and surrender ourselves to his word and to his power, that will enable us to overcome sin. You know, there is no other faith on planet earth that promises us and gives us this avenue of blessing, that we can become overcomers of the sinful flesh and the sinful nature that is within us, but for faith in Jesus Christ. Blessed be the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. There are religions that will tell you have sinned, or this is sin, or that is sin, but there is no remedy given anywhere except in and through Christ Jesus, who tells us that yes, we are sinners, and that yes, he is a savior, and that yes, by coming to him, he can help us overcome sin, and we can live triumphant, victorious lives in Christ Jesus. Amen and amen. What does that mean? Where sin abounds, we know that grace doth much more abound. So, does it give us a license to continue in sin? No. In Romans chapter 5 and verse 20, it says, where sin abounds, grace doth much more abound. But then in Romans chapter 6, it says, what shall we say then? Shall we continue in sin? And then in verse 2, it says, God forbid. God forbid. So forgiveness of sins is not available for us to take it for granted, and it is not given to us as a license to continue in sin. Psalm 102, verses 25 and 26 says, the heavens and the earth are the works of thy hands. Excuse me. And they shall perish. They shall wax old like a garment. As a vesture shalt thou change them, and they shall be changed. But, you know, we know that God's word doesn't change. Because God's word doesn't change, sometimes we think that the heavens are forever and the earth is there forever. But we read from God's word that truly what the psalmist, God's Holy Spirit, inspired the psalmist to give us this information hundreds of years ago before St. Peter wrote his epistle in 2 Peter chapter 3. We read about these facts and about these truth in 2 Peter chapter 3 verses 10 through 13. But But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in the which the heavens shall pass away, and with a great noise, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat. The earth also and all the works that are therein shall be burned up. Seeing then that all these things must be dissolved, what manner of persons ought ye to be in all holy conversation and godliness, looking for and hasting unto the coming of the day of God, wherein the heavens being on fire shall be dissolved, and the elements shall melt like fervent heat. Yes, St. Peter tells us he didn't live in a day when we had nuclear bombs or airplanes or any of these missiles. Nevertheless, the Holy Spirit, who knows yesterday, today, and tomorrow, who is also the same yesterday, today, and forever, who is the one who is inspired and given us his word, tells us and warns us hundreds of years ago through his servant, the Apostle Peter, that the heavens will melt and the earth will be dissolved. All of these things will be dissolved and all of these things will melt. But God doesn't change and his word doesn't change and his word will come to pass. So if you have put your faith in the heavens and in the earth and you think everything is going to go on like it has always gone, you're mistaken, because God's word is true. It says all of these things will melt. All of these things will dissolve. Only God's word will remain, and those who trust in God will continue on with him forever and ever. Also in the last book of the Bible, which is the book of Revelation, which talks about the end of all things, in Revelation chapter 21, we see a little glimpse, and we see how what Peter has said is the same thing that the Apostle John was inspired, and of a vision which he saw, which he penned down for us. And in Revelation chapter 21 and verse 1, I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heavens and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. Verse 2, and I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from heaven, from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a great voice of heaven saying, behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be with his people. And he shall be with his people. God himself shall be with them and be their God. You see, God doesn't change. Even the heavens above will be changed. And the earth on which we walk and live and sit and do all things, that will also be changed. God doesn't change. His word doesn't change. So if you hear about scary things, that we don't know what's going to happen in 2019, we see a lot of predictions from the secular world, from astronomers and astrologers and other faiths saying all kinds of things are going to take place in the end times. Yes, we are living in the end times. But fear not, if you are a believer in Christ Jesus, if you trust in the Lord Jesus Christ, you have nothing to fear, for he will lead you and guide you. And before all these things happen, the heavens and the earth are changed and transformed and dissolved and melt, our Lord Jesus Christ will definitely come, and he will take us to be with him forever and ever. I'll leave you with this. This is a new year. Maybe you've never accepted Jesus. This is your year. Today is your day when you can accept Jesus into your heart, into your life, as your Savior, as your Lord. You will have, I'm not promising you that you will not have difficulties. We all have difficulties. This is the lot that humankind was given to, the package that Adam and Eve received. However, with God, he makes it possible for us to go through all kinds of trials and all kinds of hardships. And he still is a loving God, a caring God, a miracle God, miracle-working God, who loves you, who cares for you, and who wants to have a personal relationship with you and give you the peace amidst chaos, peace amidst turbulence, that you may be able to be unmoved with everything that may be going on around you. God bless you, and have a blessed 2019. Pray for us. Pray for this program, that the good Lord will continue to anoint and use us to spread the gospel and to share this good news with those who have not heard it. Let us pray. Father, we commit ourselves into your hands for this new year. We know that you're in control and you're in charge. We seek your face at the beginning of this year. We seek your face. We seek your grace. We seek your mercy. We seek your love. We seek the power of your Holy Spirit to help us to lead, guide, and to live for us, live for you throughout this new year. And we will be careful, Lord, to give you glory, honor, and praise in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. God bless you.